Hi there! I'm glad to be here one more time with you in GeeklyEDU. In this video, we will study the continuity and discontinuity of the functions. It is important to have clear the concept of the limit, so let me refresh your memory. If f of x is a function defined on an interval that contains x equal to a, except possibly at x equal to a, then the limit when x approaches to a of the function will be a value equal to L in the y-axis. If for every number epsilon bigger than 0, there is another number delta bigger than 0, such as the absolute value of x minus a takes a number between 0 and delta, and the absolute value of the function f of x minus the number L is less than epsilon. It is easier to understand this concept if we see the graph. In the x-axis, we have an interval a minus delta to a plus delta. This interval contains the value a. In the same way, we have an interval in the y-axis from L minus epsilon to L plus epsilon, and this interval contains the number L. We can see that when delta takes a smaller value, that the interval is smaller, and then is when x approaches to a. To understand the concept of continuity, it's important to be familiarized with the rules of the limit. Take a screenshot of these formulas so you don't have to memorize them, and now we are ready to talk about the continuity of a function. A function is continuous in A if the limit when x approaches to A of the function of x is a function of A. It means that the point A is in the domain of the function, or as I said before, belongs to a given interval. Therefore, the evaluated limit exists, and the function of x tends to the function in the point a when x tends to a. Let's see this piecewise function graph, and we can see that the function is formed with three different expressions. From minus 4 to 0, we have a quadratic function, and then we have a jump to another quadratic function that goes from 0 to 4, and then we have a straight line. That jump in 0 tells us that the function is discontinuous in x equal to 0. This is because we can take the limit of a function from the right side or the left side, and in this case, in the point equal to 0, the limit from the left is equal to 0, but from the right side is equal to 5. Since the limits are different, the function is not continuous. It doesn't mean that all piecewise functions are discontinuous. When x is equal to 4, we have from the left side a function that tends to 68, and from the right side the limit is also 68. Therefore, we only have one discontinuity. We will talk about this later, and so you can understand it better. Some theorems that you should keep in mind are these. All polynomial functions are continuous in all real numbers. All rational functions are continuous when the function is defined. This means that the denominator is different to 0. Root functions are continuous when the roots exist. Remember that not all roots are real, so you should be careful if you are working only with real numbers, because these functions are defined when the roots are real bigger than 0. Otherwise, the roots are always defined in complex numbers. Another theorem is that all trigonometrical functions are continuous in its domains. Remember that the domain is not always the real numbers. For example, for the function tangent, it is defined in its domain, but for some values of x, it's not defined. Also, exponential and logarithmic functions are continuous in its domain when the value exists. If you're not familiar with the domain of the functions, you can go to our functions and trigonometrical functions videos in this channel. Okay, let's begin the fun part, that is using the concepts in an example. The first one is to determine if this rational function is continuous. By the theorem I just gave you, we can say that this function is continuous in its domain. But what is that domain? Rational functions are defined when the denominator is different to zero. In this case, when x is equal to minus 3, the denominator is equal to 0, and the domain of the function is all real numbers different to minus 3. But as you can see, this function can be simplified, factorizing the numerator as the product of x plus 3 and x plus 5, and as one term of the denominator is the same as the numerator, we can cancel those terms and finally have the function expressed as x plus 5. This is one case of a removable discontinuity in x equal to minus 3. Another example is to determine if a function is continuous in a given point, in this case in minus 5. Finding the limit of the function when x approaches to the given point plus 5, we have 1 divided by 0. This means that the function is not defined in that point, and therefore we have an asymptotical or infinite discontinuity in 5. Let's solve one last example of a piecewise function. We know that the function will be continuous in a point if the left and right limit of the function in a given point are equal. First, calculate the limit from the left. When the function is x squared and x tends to 0, the limit is equal to 0. And evaluating the limit from the right, when the function is minus 2x plus 6, we will evaluate the limit in 0 and it gives us 6. In this case, the limits are different, and therefore, we have a discontinuity. This type of discontinuity in 0 is called a jump discontinuity. That is all for today, but before you go, tell us in the comments below how many discontinuities does this piecewise function has, and of what type.
Now that you watched this video, you're one step closer to achieving your academic goals. Well done! There's always more to learn, so check out our other videos and don't forget to subscribe.